welcome back to the Lord.
When I was young, I never needed anyone, and making love was just for fun.
Oh, tell me about it, Eric.
Those days are gone.
So far gone.
Living alone, I think of all the friends I've known. But when I dial the telephone, nobody's home.
Eric Carmen, all by myself, and welcome to the Lords of Loud. It's another isolation special, and as will soon become very clear, it's just me, Lord Kev, tonight, fully isolated, all by myself, and yeah, sad times. I hope you're doing well. Tonight's subject is non-viral novelty songs. You might well say, why enough non-viral novelty songs? Well, first, a little background, a little story. The genesis for this, the inspiration maybe, very weird thing happened. Lord Ben and I, in fact, turned up to do a recording session for the Lords. Usually there's four of us, tonight just one. On this occasion, two of us arrived to record Lords Aloud, and we were locked out of the building. Curiouser and curiouser, not only locked out, but all I remember is that I passed out at some point while we waited to be let in. There was the smell of gas, something was afoot. I passed out. Somehow I got home, as I say, got myself isolated. And, I remember hearing some music that evening. We heard the KLF. I think I heard some Liam Lynch, some Crazy Frog. And it turned out that the other two Lords had recorded a special on novelty songs, viral hits. That swept the nation, and they kicked off with a couple of belters that my kids love, You Whatever, by Liam Lynch, and Crazy Frog, the most detestable song to ever be placed on any recording medium, and that's got some stiff competition. I don't have any doubts about that. I got home and these songs were in my head, and lo and behold, it was the boys playing their favourite novelty songs, and I kind of had to take issue. Well, not issue, I mean, I was inspired, or took issue, or was inspired, you know, depending on how you're going to look at this. First up, really, I've got to start with Elvis. Now, Elvis put out a song called What Does the Fox Say? And What Does the Fox Say was pretty brutally bad. You know, when it became a viral hit, and you know, a lot of people quite rightly hated it. What a lot of people don't know is that Elvis, some Scandinavian dudes, actually recorded a lot of other songs. Albums worth, in fact, of parody songs, novelty songs, each one with a very specific genre. And a lot of them very, very funny. They did a song called Trucker's Hitch, which was, you know, perfect version of a new Western country, new country, with the whole, you know, backbeat and the sort of three-part harmony here and there. And, you know, they've done a song called, a boy band song called The Language of Love, in which a man falls for a seal. Not the seal, Alan, but a seal. And fantastic videos to go along with it. So what I'm going to do in terms of non-viral novelty songs, first up is play some Elvis. This is a song called Stonehenge. I think you'll get the vibe pretty quickly.
There were 25 tons each storm, my friend, but amazingly they got them all down in the sand. And they moved it, Stonehenge. And they dragged it, Stonehenge. And they rolled it 46 miles from where.
So there we go, just a little blast of Elvis getting pretty epic with their song Stonehenge. And ironic, of course, that the Lords in fact did mention the other Stonehenge song, the Spinal Tap's epic. But I think you can agree just from a little bit of that they've really nailed a particular type of song there. And that's what they proved to have done very well with the songs that they've put out. Great lyrics, it's the greatest henge of all that kind of stuff. What's the meaning of Stonehenge? I can guarantee that the first time I got into that, I laughed like a drain. But of course it went nowhere, absolutely nowhere. Now a lot of the music I like does go nowhere, so it's perfectly fitting that that's exactly what went down. Yeah, I'm just gonna put it out there as my number one. I guess it's a reactive in response to those lords. Let's call them the lockout lords, just to be fair, or cruel or fair, depending on what's your take on it. Yeah, that's what they went into. They went into some Elvis straight away, and some lesser known stuff there by the same band, which is well worth checking out, I'd have to say. So moving along here. We're going straight into another, I guess, my past. Not so reactive. This one's a pure novelty song, purely from my own history. Not so much inspired by what the kids enjoy or anything like that. Maybe I'll just give you a bit of history to this. The Scotland football team have not qualified for the World Cup for a long time. But back in the 70s, when I was a nipper, they used to do with alarming regularity, and their confidence got way up, too far up. A small nation back in the day who would often appear at the world stage, as they used to call it. They started recording songs about how confident they were, songs like 1978's Ali's Army. We're on the march with Ali's Army, we're going to the Argentine, we'll really shake them up when we win the World Cup, because Scotland is the greatest football team. Of course, we get kicked out in the first round, as we always do. This was on the back of other pretty overconfident Scotland football team songs pre-World Cups. In 1974, we brought out a song called Easy Easy, in which we told everyone how easy it was going to be for us to win everything, and had the similar result at the finals. By 1982, when I was in primary school, even I knew that we weren't going to win the thing, and their expectations were lowered, and we fell back on our sense of humour, and we brought out a song called We Have a Dream, in which the Scotland team and various musicians get together to explain that the chance of us scoring a penalty in the World Cup finals was quite literally that. We'll have a listen to a little blast of it, and you'll get a sense of the thing.
He looks to his linesman, and he's pointing straight at the spot.
That's the penalty spot.
The John Roberts, who normally takes them, is handing the ball to me. My old lady screaming blue murder. She's saying, it's got the ball, you're kicking, you're eating. It's me. I have a dream.
We
we go. The voice in that is actually actor John Gordon Sinclair, well known inside Scotland as Gregory from Gregory's Girl. And as part of us all growing up, it was great to see a sense of humour being brought to the situation, which, quite frankly, 4 years before, had ended up with us all with a bit of egg on our face, with, as I say, the overconfidence. But of course, the song, you know, would not be well known outside the UK, and to anyone under probably 20 or so, at the very least. So, yeah, definitely... a Novelty song that did not go viral, and my second choice of that particular weird category. But let's go now to number three. And yeah, you might have heard some odd sounds in the background as I've been chatting along tonight. I've had on an album here and there, you may have heard some sheep, you may have heard some Tuvan throat singing. Believe it or not, this is the KLF. Now, the K... yeah, just turned down the Tuvan throat singing there for a minute. The KLF's, album, Chill Out album, it was called, was brought out maybe a couple of years after, you know, right in the pocket of their first hit singles that went out underground, and it was a completely different thing to the viral hits that they did have with Novelty songs. Their Last Train's to Central, Transcentral, and their, as I think the other Lords played, the Lockout Lords, remember them, they played, I think it was Doctor in the TARDIS, a song written specifically to be number one. And what are they doing in the background? Here's a 44 minute single track album of more sounds than you can shake a stick at. Just some glorious, you know, selections of music. Interesting soundscapes. Supposedly this is a train journey that that Bill Drummond's taken across America. The signifying track names, although it all blends into one piece of music, seem to suggest that that's what's happened and that's the story that goes along with it. This track, at about 17 minutes, it's called Justified and Ancient. Seems a long time ago. The next track up is Elvis on the Radio, Steel Guitar in My Soul. So not exactly what they were known for at exactly the same time in the charts. They seem to have gone on an art experiment, both commercial and creative. And fair play to them for that.
On a cold and gray Chicago morning, a poor little baby child was born in the ghetto. That is mama cries. But if there's one thing she don't need, it's another hungry mouth to feed in the ghetto.
If you're unlucky enough to have worked with me in a sort of in an office situation over the last, say, 10, 20 years, you would know this is my late at night working to stuff album. Just gets me through when I just don't want to be doing stuff anymore and I just need to sort of have something that distracts me from the job I'm doing. Yeah, so there we go. The KLF doing something pretty far out, man. Definitely not a hit. Definitely Novelty. I might just skip ahead a little bit in the album to a song called Wichita Lineman. Was a song I once heard in which there's a little bit of beat drops in and he starts to drop in samples of radio evangelists. Yes, I'm that preacher everybody's talking about. Says Dr. Weir's giving out some red hot lessons, tearing down New York and New Jersey every week, all the way down the East Coast. Plenty of great stuff going on in that, and a personal favourite of mine and hugely unsuccessful. But now let's play something completely different.
Another beer, Pops?
Yeah, you're speaking English.
Freezing cold in 89 years old.
You the cold maids say one. Freezing cold in 89 years old. All right.
When I stay in the shoes now, I'll hold me the same. Then a whole red maybe get the color boss dying.
Ah yes, Swango and Stussy from Fargo, the series 3. Fargo 3, the series? The series of Fargo 3, the third series of... I'm watching this show, I love Fargo, the series, I love the music in it. And this track pops up and I'm playing you the clip from the TV show. Because in context, it was used beautifully. And there's a lot of theory about the music that the Coen brothers choose. This same particular series had to do with subterfuge at a kind of a corporate level and misinformation. The song is Prison Call an Einstein Chusol by the Italian superstar Adriano Celentano, or is it Celentano? Point is, this is a novelty song on a level that few others are. What he's doing is making up his own language. He's singing in words that don't exist to make it sound like he's singing in English, when in fact it's basically what English sounds like to Italians. So there are no words, despite YouTube and the internet at large being full of interpretations of the lyrics, some of them gibberish, some of them actual words. The man himself was trying to make a point that American English takes over the world, and as long as you do a song in American English, this is what people want to hear, they'll recognise it and they'll hum along. A big deal in the 60s. It's also a hugely unusual song. It's hugely strange little beat, strange chorus, the spoken to and fro, him and his wife no less. But you know, the thing that really got me about it was just the depth of the message that he was trying to convey in this strange little track. And definitely a novelty song, definitely non-viral, I think that's fair to say. You know, an absolute belter of a tune, real quirky and a lot of fun. As I say, it just has the strangest pretext for any song you're ever going to hear. See if you can work out what it's getting.
I never need
making love was just for fun.
May have dropped a bit of Eric back into the middle there, but it's time to say goodbye. I hope you've enjoyed this little collection. Basically, it was a strange night hearing all these things the boys were playing, and I was inspired to think about what other novelty songs were out there, and of course, I found ones that, yeah, just nobody's ever heard, and possibly never wanted to. So, thanks for listening. I'm out. Stay well. Stay isolated. Stay by yourself. No hugging. Wash your hands.